It's for me a very special moment to welcome you for this extraordinary event, which should celebrate solidarity. Solidarity, particularly with the Ukrainian people, but solidarity with everybody who suffers in our world. Music is the language of the heart. So we will have this evening a great message coming out of the heart. It's not just a musical performance, because we will greet, I could introduce them as world famous artists, but I introduce them also as great, great humanists. So let's welcome as soon as they come on stage, let's wait. So I keep you curious whom you will see now. So, two world-famous artists, you see here, Mr. Axe, Emanuel Axe, and Yo-Yo Ma. I have to share with you also one secret. Yo-Yo Ma is also a member of our board of trustees. You see, the World Economic Forum integrates the voice of the art, the voice of the heart in its activities. So I'm now quiet, and please enjoy a wonderful hour.
Thank you so much, Professor Schwab, for your kind words. Before we begin, I'd just like to ask my great friend and colleague, Emanuel Axe, to say a couple of words about what we're about to play.
So I'm so happy to be here. Thank you for letting me join you. I know that we are all engulfed by the horrific events in Eastern Europe. As it happens, I actually was born in the city that's very much in the news these days, Lviv. My father was born in the same city when it was called Lemberg, and it was part of the Austro-Hungarian Empire. My mother was born in the same city when it was called Lvov and was Poland. I was born in the same city when it was called Lvov and the Soviet Union. And now it's Lviv in the Ukraine. Of course, I'm not Ukrainian in any way, but I share with the rest of the world the sympathy and the hope for all of the people of Lviv and the Ukraine. And we would like to dedicate the Ukrainian national anthem. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. The next piece that Manny and I would like to play for you is the Beethoven Sonata Opus 69 for piano and cello that we started playing almost 50 years ago. I know we don't look so old, but that is indeed, in fact, true. But 2 years ago, in the midst of the pandemic, Manny found a quote that I thought it might be interesting for him to tell us about.
So when Beethoven sent the manuscript of this piece to his sponsor, he wrote a Latin inscription. I'm afraid I can't repeat the Latin, but it was amid tears and sorrow. And we don't really know if this was Beethoven's hand, but I would like to believe that it was, because in fact, what he was living through was a time of strife not unlike our own. He was in Vienna. The city was being bombarded by Napoleon's armies. And even with his growing deafness, he often had to hide in the cellar just from the sheer noise of the cannon firing and the bombs. And the incredible thing to us is that this piece is so full of strength and defiance, but above all, of hope and somehow positivity. This music is so generous and so flowing, overflowing with beauty and hope that I think we can all learn from Beethoven that there are ways to overcome, and we hope to get through all of this and be better people again.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. So we would like to play one last piece for you. And this is from a hero of both Manny's and mine, a cellist named Pablo Casals, whom you may have heard of, who actually stopped playing after World War II in protest of the Allies not overthrowing and toppling the regime of Franco. But he would occasionally take out the cello and play at the United Nations or wherever. And his favorite piece of music to play was the Song of the Birds, a folk song from Catalonia. He was a Catalan. And for him, it was a song of freedom, flight of birds, freedom for humans, the song of the birds.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you, all of you. And now, I would like to invite Hilde to come on stage, who thought of this wonderful gathering. And maybe you can send us off with a couple of words for what we can think about.
Thank you. I have this evening, arts and culture have united us. They have touched our minds, our souls, and our hearts. Through the power of music, we have been invited to reflect upon our world and our shared humanity. In challenging times, music helps us maintain our hope, our empathy, and our compassion towards one another, and this has never been more important than now. I invite you to carry this moment with you.